It's time to put on our thinking caps and interpret the significance of what we've been exploring. Unless it explains, history is trivial. Did you find much this week that needs to be explained? What surprised you this week? Did you make any unexpected discoveries? What was the most meaningful part of your explorations this week? In your exploration of Stonehenge, you encountered many different explanations of how Stonehenge was used. Interpretations of Stonehenge have varied immensely over time and continue to be disputed even today. Without written texts from its makers to guide us, how can we take steps to ensure that our interpretations are warranted and not merely subjective speculations? How might we minimize our inherent human tendencies toward presentism and rational reconstruction? Did it surprise you to discover that people in the Middle Ages knew the Earth was round? Was there evidence for the spherical Earth convincing? Had you thought of those arguments before? If not, why not? When you watched the Flat Earth video, were you surprised by the narrator's contention that students in medieval universities understood more about observational astronomy than university students do today? Granted that it was intended to be provocative, do you think he went too far? What was the point he was driving at? Remember George Gamow, the eminent 20th century astrophysicist? Just try to count the errors in this brief opening paragraph from his article on gravity published in Scientific American in March 1961. Gamow wrote, "In the days when civilized men believed that the world was flat, they had no reason to think about gravity. There was up and down. All material things tended naturally to move downward or to fall, and no one thought to ask why. The notion of absolute up and down directions persisted into the Middle Ages, when it was still invoked to prove that the Earth could not be round." End quote. Where does one even begin to clear up the confusion in cases like this? First of all, we've seen that ever since Aristotle, people have had a lot of reasons to think about gravity. Aristotle's theory of natural place explained why earthy things naturally move downward. When Gamow describes Aristotle's theory, he fails to grasp that this very theory of natural place requires the Earth to be round. According to Aristotle, the Earth could not possibly be any other shape. Aristotle's notions of up and down directions persisted into the Middle Ages, along with the understanding that the Earth must be a globe. The round shape of the Earth could not be doubted wherever Aristotle was accepted. So all this leads us to a puzzle. Can you explain how an eminent modern scientist like Gamow could be so wrong about the history of science? If the flat Earth myth is not medieval belief in a flat Earth, but rather the mistaken modern notion that people in the Middle Ages thought the Earth was flat when they actually knew the Earth was round, then what are the implications? Are you puzzled by why the flat Earth myth is so durable? Are you disturbed by what the flat Earth myth suggests about our understanding of the history of science? If so many people get the story of the shape of the Earth wrong, and if so many people hold unwarranted beliefs about Stonehenge, then what else in the history of science might we be mistaken about? In his book, Inventing the Flat Earth, medieval historian Geoffrey Burton Russell concluded with a poignant observation. I can do no better than to quote his words. "The search for truth is long and laborious and easily set aside. And since the present is transformed day by day, minute by minute, second by second, into the past, while the future is unknown and unknowable, we are left on the dark sea without stars, without compass or astrolabe, more unsure of our position and our goal than any of Columbus's sailors. The terror of meaninglessness, of falling off the edge of knowledge, is greater than the imagined fear of falling off the edge of the earth. And so we prefer to believe a familiar error than to search unceasingly the darkness. How can we be more like the figure in the woodcut and push through the darkness to see new worlds beyond?